Hello, Sam. That is off mic. So, I've been away working on this. So, final ideas. Why is this doing this? I swear to God, sometimes this thing is annoying as shit. But nonetheless, right, let's show you what I've been up to. Minimize that there. So last we put down our ideas and then came this. I'm not gonna lie, there's been a bit of procrastination. I said that right, yeah. Going on, I haven't really felt like I've just dawdled around the ideas a lot. But here's the final ideas. This is the flesh out ideas stage. So the character, so I'll just name this ball balance game. Original idea, I know. And here we go. The character, some person slash thing on a ball. I just don't want it to be, I guess, in an ideal world, you could have any thin beer. Like, you go select character, you can be like male, female, other, animal, whatever, you know? Hell, just do like an alien, like a green alien, just be a bubble ball running around on it. Right, design. Start on a flat surface, where you must use the movement keys to balance on the ball for a certain amount of time. That was idea one, where it was like, balance on the ball for 30 seconds to win. So you do that. The idea, it starts off easy on a flat surface and slowly ramps up. Other idea is there's levels. So level one is a flat, you just gotta stay there for so many seconds, and it slowly builds up. You can also have like a, it just is a time thing in overall. Here's some quick doodles I did. I'm no artist, so apologies. And I also had to use my iPad on this, so I was like, dee-dee-dee. But I guess it shows off in my head what it would kind of look like, I guess. There's the ball, your character on top, it moves in any of those directions. Obviously, you don't control it, you're just trying to balance on that. So you'd have to code the ball to go randomly in places. And this is what it would look like top down. So you got your time. It looks real squished. Sadly, I can't. Can I make a real chunk? That looks horrible. But yeah, so top down, there'd be like that sort of object. So you'd be like, oh, cool. Hopefully, yeah, you can see my mess. There'd be this object here. And it'd be like, oh, I gotta dodge that. No. You wouldn't dodge the object, you'd hit into it, and your ball would bounce about. I guess it'd be kind of weird. It's kind of weird. I guess it would be less objects. Maybe. I guess you hit into it and then you bounce this way, so you gotta like counteract it. Again, here's some. That was like top down. I was like, it doesn't really feel in your face enough, you know, like you're balancing, you're kind of like this looking down, so you don't get the depth of anything. So here was like a more third person behind sort of view. Here you'd see like the holes and stuff. Maybe you could fall down into different layers, I don't know, fall down and go into an underground level. But yeah, you'd like have to dodge a, is it Skellig? Skellig might. Mites go up, tights go down, right? Skellig. Tight, Skellig might. One or the other, I'm not entirely sure. But yeah, again, you would be bounced on this ball, dodging left and, well, not dodging, but trying to balance on the ball as it hits these objects. The ice car game, let's simplify that right down. The character, I put car slash driver. Again, there could be a thing where you don't even see the driver, you just see the car, and you can choose between a red car, a blue car, a green car, whatever. Again, dodging holes in the ice. Design dodge holes on the ice. Dodge things on top, so you'd have potholes in the water. I think these drawings came out okay. The car. Apologies again for the dodgy artwork, but yeah, dodge things on the ice, so like skidding around, sliding around, mission like tree trunks, trees, other people on them. Maybe there's some like people just fishing, ice fishing. Ooh, what am I, mic? ES just popped. Yeah, dodging the ice. You also have like holes in the ice, you can fall down, game over sort of thing. Movement changes. So for ages, say it will be like W will be going, I don't know, like the left will be steering you like this, but then it'll like switch to do that or something. You can have it like mixing it up, just so then it keeps like the player, I guess it gives them that like, it does feel out of control and not like they're in control, you know? Like, because at first, if you know how to sort of, if it's like difficult controls, it'll take a while for them to get used to it, but once they get used to it, it'll be in their control. This way, when it's switching around, it gives that player that more feeling of, uh-oh, I don't know how to control this. So yeah, the idea again, stages / levels. Each level gets harder, so at first there might only be like three obstacles you need to dodge, and whatever. Each level would get more and more props and props and props, and then in theory you'd only need to do like, what, we'll say like a hole, a tree, a person, and a rock. Boom. Four things. At no level, it would start off fairly easy, and then sort of like the map would expand, I guess. The longer you were going, the more things would start spawning. So, first 30 seconds, there's only like 10 things, so forth, so on, so forth, I guess, increasingly harder. Here's some pictures, so sort of like a top down idea again. Could also do it like a third person, sort of like the camera being like weirdly sleeping behind. Ooh, that might feel cool. I could put like on a camera boom. Boom? Boom? Boom. I'm gonna go with boom. And it sort of like sloshes side to side on the ice as you slide around. Be kind of cool. But yeah, again, here was sort of like a top down sort of view. Here's a person standing there, and you sort of like slide around them. Next, the broken robot idea. I think I might go with this one. I kind of like this. I feel like this is simple enough for me to do. So, the robot. Robot has been issued to death. I probably need to change that to sentenced, but I'll change that. Design. The player can see the robot's body parts get turned off. So the idea for that was kind of like in this lovely UI down here where you got your little robot, bad, and exit. You'll see what gets turned off, but you can also see it on the character. So say if Q was to pick something up, I haven't put anything down for Q yet, but say Q was pick up like a box and drop it, Q would be broken. So you would just be like, yeah, I'll also just be like this. And when they're turned off, it would, you'd physically see it on the character. I think that would be a kind of a neat trick to also give more visual aid to the player instead of just having to see the buttons up in the top. I guess it would just be like grayed out and it'd be beep, 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 boosh, switch sort of thing. But yeah, like you'd have your classic movements. As like E for interact, you could push some buttons, I don't know. But I was also thinking like, say if, oh, you can't interact, how are you going to do it then? You could do like a, ooh, I could hit control and have it like a slam down ability, so he like jumps up on a control panel and slams down, breaks it, but it activates it sort of thing. Well, it's kind of cool. Each level will add a new button. So the first one, it'll be like, you can't move left or right, and then you have to get to the end. I'd probably pick right just because you'd go left to right, so you'd be stuck, so you couldn't move right, but the timer would boop, boop, and switch. Yeah, something like that. Timer would not work. Well, I could have the timer work, the character couldn't move, so then like, how am I supposed to get from A to B? maybe the jump doesn't go up, it does like a upright, so you jump it across. Or you could do a thing where the character looks backwards and moves that way, if you know what I mean. So, say if they can't move that way, I look that way, I can't move, but if I look that way, I can then walk backwards. I guess that kind of sort of like trickery you could do. But yeah, then again, each level will add more and more things. But each level would be designed around a button or an action, and then that would be taken away until the end where it's like, here's a mixture. Or level 1 would show you can't jump. Level 2 would be like, you can't move right. And then that would also have bits from level 1 where you can't jump, sort of thing. I don't know, I'm gonna have a mess about with it and see what I can do, but I think this robot idea is the best. I kind of like these ideas, but I think the robot one is the one to go for at the moment. So hopefully by the next episode I'll have some basic blocks. I'll probably just have like some very, very basic stuff. But yeah, hopefully you guys enjoyed. Again, this is more just rambling, my thought process behind everything. I'm not sure if I'm going to upload these. These are more for myself, I guess. So I can look back and be like, oh, that's why I came up with this, I guess. But thanks for watching, and see you in the next episode. Peace.